bladder and bowel dysfunction, or BBD.
It's a medical term for peeing and related pooping problems. It's also called voiding dysfunction, dysfunctional elimination, or incontinence.
Hi, I'm Abby. I'm the nurse practitioner in the Urology Department at the Hospital for Sick Children. We see many children in our clinic for bowel and bladder issues.
In otherwise healthy children, a problem with peeing is often a learned behavior where the muscles that are used to pee, and sometimes the muscles that are used to poop, can be used incorrectly, causing unwanted pee and sometimes poop accidents.
The good news is that over time, it can be corrected with bladder and bowel retraining at home and at school.
Bladder and bowel retraining is not about the child alone. It's also working together as a team. First, let's look at the system we use to pee.
The kidneys, bladder, ureters, and urethra are all part of the urinary system. Urine, or pee, is produced by the kidneys and then flows via the ureters into the bladder where it is stored. When the bladder is full, a signal is sent to the brain. The detrusor muscle in the bladder wall contracts, and the sphincter muscles that surround the neck of the bladder and the urethra are allowed to relax. The pee can then move through the urethra and the bladder can empty. Bladder and bowel dysfunction occurs when the signal from the brain is ignored and the muscles involved in peeing are not allowed to relax. This can happen, for example, when your child is playing or distracted doing something they enjoy and does not want to take a break to go pee. Instead, they hold it. Some signs that this may be happening with your child include crossing their legs, heel sitting, and holding their genitals. Unfortunately, adults often need to go to the toilet at the most inconvenient times, and it's no different for children. But when a child regularly ignores their body's urge to pee, it can confuse their urinary system, and peeing problems or bladder and bowel dysfunction can occur. Constipation can also cause or contribute to bladder issues. Constipation can occur the same way bladder dysfunction can, when a child ignores their body's urge to go to the toilet, and the feces, or poop, stays in the bowel. This side view of the body shows where the bowel is located in relation to the urinary system. If too much poop is held in the bowel, it can cause it to stretch. When the bowel is stretched, it can press against the bladder. This can interfere with the ability of the bladder to fill and empty properly. These are illustrations of different forms of poop. If your child's poop doesn't look like number 4 or 5, your child may have constipation. Bladder and bowel retraining helps you and your child create good peeing and pooping habits that will help your child's urinary system work properly again.
Work together with your child and you can find a lot more success. Your child will really need your help to continue to positively work through the program. Be patient, be persistent. Bladder and bowel retraining works for most kids who go through this process.
Go to aboutkidshealth.ca to learn more about bladder retraining or ask your child's healthcare provider for tips.